My name is Kevin Grazier. I am a planetary scientist. For my research, I do long-term integrations or simulations of early solar system evolution. And a former scientist on the Cassini mission, I'm also a consultant to several TV series like Defiance, Falling Skies, the movie Gravity, and formerly Battlestar Galactica. Cassini has essentially rewritten the book on the Saturn system. I was on the spacecraft team for 15 years. I worked as a science planner and as the investigation scientist on the ISS instrument, that's Imaging Science Subsystem, not International Space Station. And of the discoveries that we found, I'm trying to think of what I would classify as the most exciting. Several. One was predicted, the fact that it was believed there could be ice volcanoes on Enceladus, and as a matter of fact, there are ice volcanoes on Enceladus, or active venting, however you want to look at that, and that vent creates the E-ring. So we have a ring created by material vented off Enceladus. That's pretty exciting, because we see an object, an active object, venting material. There aren't a lot of active objects in the solar system. The surface of Titan is really fantastic. We have open oceans, we have or seas of hydrocarbons on Titan. We have the possibility of an ocean underneath the icy crust, just like we believe is under the surface of Europa. We have one image which seemed to capture what might be a volcanic eruption. That's important because in the outer solar system, planetary scientists consider ice a rock. What a rock is defined as depends where you are in the solar system. In an outer solar system, ice is a rock. All the moons in the outer solar system, except Io, have icy crusts. Now, if we have a volcanic eruption on Titan, we have an eruption of magma. And if ice is a rock, that volcanic eruption is water. So we have evidence of magma chambers, which could be cauldrons of life-giving liquid water. How cool is that? And how counterintuitive is that? How science fiction is that? That one of the most interesting places to look for is a lava chamber or a magma chamber on another planet that could be a cauldron of life suitable for sustaining life. I think that's really, really exciting.
Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel here. And maybe you still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see what you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.
Pay no attention to the guy behind the curtain.